Burbex.
Way too easy to get into. Nobody's been here for a long time. These footstools. The rot is in every surface. Look at these chairs. The woodworm is attacking everything. Oh, that's super cute. I bet that'd be so comfortable to sit on. Goodness. amazing because it's totally abandoned. It's so cool in here. It's about 32 Celsius outside. But in here it's quite cool. The carvings. You can see little lions up there. It's so intricate. I've come past this place several times and I've always wanted to go in. Looks like some kind of museum. It's petrified wood. It's fossilized wood. The building is talking to me. Look at these curtains. This is so spooky. It smells sublime in here. Everything smells like pine wood. Some kind of water feature outside. Details in the woodwork here. Lots of fishing nets. People fish for these tiny little shrimp around here. And they use these very fine nets. Nothing can get out of that. Some beads. The staff room, and of course everywhere we go there's a bawan hat, a security hat, but no security here. Time stopped at 20 to 1, but like they say, even a stopped clock tells the right time twice a day. It's a tiny pair of scales, it's for weighing tea. It seems to be a tea shop. Here's all the weights inside. Now it says 50 grams. 50 grams, that sounds like a lot. So many teapots. Let's go see what's upstairs. Look, they put this, they put incense inside it, and you can see there's a light inside as well. So the light would be glowing through the smoke. That would look quite romantic. Wow, this place is big. It smells so good in here. Some of these teapots look quite valuable. I don't know if you can see them in the dark there. I love these chairs. Everything here is so perfectly carved. Look at all the little carvings in the doors here. This guy looks a bit shifty. This guy too. Look at this key. It seems to be shaped like an axe. Some of these cups. I'll take some of them over to the table to show you. These things all appear to be incense burners. You put the incense in here and then you burn it. Again, this one, you open it up, you can put the incense inside and then it would burn through. And there's an even smaller one just here. They're so nicely designed. These are all teacups. I can't believe this place is empty. Feels like a museum. Look at these guys. Looking at the moon. This is like a tea house. So people come to sip tea in a comfortable place. Here you can see a tea tray. This is used for the Chinese tea ceremony. The tea leaves are put in this, and you can see there's like a net in there, and then the water is poured through there and then poured into the cups. We don't have any cups though. These are all the implements. There's like some tweezers for picking up tea. That's the scoop for the tea. This is like the pick in case your teapot spout gets bunged up. And this is just some random scoop. I think we're coming into the luxury room now. Wow. Oh, there's a dead bird on the table. I'm not sure if that's good luck or not. There's Buddha with his staff made out of wood. That's beautiful. Look, here's a more advanced tea set. This one's got the teapot with it. That's a big teapot. It's another of these couches. Some kind of padlock, an ancient Chinese padlock. That's so interesting. Never seen that before. Seems to be another incense burner. If you want to squat anywhere in Shanghai, this place would be ideal. This weird statue. Looks like the guy's got his tongue sticking out. Seems to be holding a biscuit or something. And then he's got really long, fat legs. What a weird face. Some treasure in there. Looks more like Western style though. Oh look, this is salt and pepper shaker in the shape of Buddha. What strange little objects. I've got a hole in the bottom. Lots of little holes in the top. I guess they could be incense burners. So many little cups.